what's gonna get you killed? The price gonna be the death of you.
Action. Bollocks.
Filmmaking is one of the great loves of mine. I love filmmaking. I love like making films. I can see myself in the future being someone who creates films. And when I'm a millionaire, having made an extensive catalogue of films, my wife, she's all sad and saggy and wrinkly and all that. I'll be smooth, happy, sag less, and I'll still be the main character of all my films. I've been making films for years, like years and years. I think like 6 or 7. When I was like 10, we went to the local park and we filmed this thing called Teleporting Man, where we basically cut the video and made it look like we were teleporting around the local park. It's not much, but you know, every success story has its humble beginnings.
Fuck. Cut.
Mom, I'm locked out. Yeah, I know I had a key, but I think I lost it. Look, okay, calm. Why are you so mad? Calm down, okay? I mean, I see people driving here all the time. It's only a 20-minute drive. You can just come and let me in and then go back to work. No, come on, don't hang up. Please. Can you just come back? Please. Fuck. I'll get you hung up. We're fucked.
It's my dogs.
They're stuck inside. Uh-oh. My windows are open, but I can't get in up there.
Yeah, that's really what sparked it. And then, after that, made a little YouTube channel. Well, it wasn't little. It was actually quite good. It's probably better than any of the shit you lot have made at the BBC.
Come in. This is mi casa, es su casa.
It got taken down after we made a, what they called, racist diss track on a fellow classmate. I personally didn't find it offensive, so I'm not sure why they did. I mean, all we said was... But yeah, anyways, it had a good ending. I like dark endings where like most of the characters die, which is basically what happened to the channel. It's a staple aspect of most of my other works. Since then, I've dipped my toes in most genres. Let's see, I'll list them off for you. We got heist movie, bosh. Spy movie, bosh. Thriller, like yes sir, and sci-fi.
For the resistance!
But wait, there's more. Adventure, mystery, sports, indie, found footage. I even made a silent film. I've basically done everything. If you notice the trend in most of my films is that I have an irrational fear of franchises. So much so I don't even eat at Subway. So I kill off all the main characters in my movie so that there's no possible way a sequel could ever be made. I also cram as much as I physically can into one movie so the audience gets everything they want from it.
That's my dog. Her name's Coco. She's the best. This is my room. Please excuse the mess. I've just been making loads of stuff. I haven't really had time to, you know, clean up. That's my mate Josh. He's playing like Pokemon Go on his phone. So I just ignore him. He's not important. Right. So. Alright. Oh no, not that. Hold on. Right here. Bedfordshire Film Festival 2022. Will I be entering? Of fucking course I'll be entering. I fucking ace these tournaments. Up to a grand in prize money. Deadline's in a month though. I think I work better under pressure. Anyway, but I hope the prize is fucking the grand.
So you have an idea then?
Huh?
You've got an idea then?
Yeah, I've got an idea.
What is your idea?
Well, don't push it out on me, alright? I need some more time.
Well, I'm guessing you don't have an idea then.
Who the fuck do you think you are? You the fucking KGB or something? Fucking interrogating me? Leave me alone.
So you have no idea.
Right, okay, get out. Get out. Get the camera off Josh as well.
I'm meant to be documenting you.
No, give me the camera. I'll document the bastard myself. I'll do a better job than you ever did anyway, dickhead. Fucking prick. Right. Is it on? I think that light. Yeah, that light's flashing. Alright.
Why did you end up procrastinating all night?
Because the cameraman was being a dickhead. He was just like, oh, you don't have an idea, you, when I obviously do have an idea, I just don't want to tell him it. Like, he's just being a pushy creep, you know?
Okay, so when we get into the classroom, just try and keep it low-key, keep the camera down, because it's going to be a bit suspicious if I just rock up after 4 years, you know? So, you know, I'm just your average college student trying to check his work on his computer.
If you've been at college for 4 years, why have you still got the lanyard?
Nah, he's not left yet. I mean, if you believe that, you're a moron. He's not even finished his first year yet. I don't think he passed any of his projects.
He's a very particular person. I think he was neglected as a child, as he seems to, you know, crave validation from other people.
Yeah, he's a fucking prick. I hate him.
Okay, let me just log on.
That's okay. He's a grandma lady.
No, she's not.
Right. Come on, there's got to be something down there.
So, is this your account then?
Nah, this is someone else's. That's why it's so shit, you know? Wait, hold on, look at that. And then look at this. I've just had an idea. Come with me.
While staring at Reese Witherspoon's shirt, I was struck with an idea. What is she wearing? A flannel shirt. What am I wearing? A flannel shirt. What's on the back of my shirt? A bloody cowboy. What would be a good idea for a short film? A cowboy film. Why? Cowboys are sound.
Hold on. My teacher must have spotted me. He wants to like catch up or something. I'll catch up with you guys later. You alright?
Getting kicked out of college is probably one of the darkest points in my life. I mean, I don't think many things compare in comparison to being kicked out of college. Like, that's your life's work. You know, you spend however many years you are in preschool, primary school, upper school, all that shit. Then there's college afterwards, college after that. And just getting kicked out of that after all that time, it's just kicking the balls, honestly. I just feel betrayed. I don't think anything has hurt me this bad since my diagnosis with hay fever. I mean, that was a rough patch as well. God.
We're going location scouting to look for some new, you know, like some new locations for my new Western film. Haven't seen any right now. What a tragedy. Who would do such a thing? I need some space. What do you mean, why are we here? I thought you were a filmmaker. We're here to locate... Oh, actually, that's nice. Look at that. We're here to location scout for my new film.
So you've had an idea?
Yeah, I have had an idea. A cowboy movie.
You said you've been inspired.
I was inspired by my shirt. Imagine the interviews. It's like, oh, how did you come up with the idea for your, Oscar-winning short film? I looked at my shirt and I was like, that's that.
Hypothetical doesn't exist for me. I imagine interviews in that in the near future because I'm certain they're going to come to fruition. If I just keep dedicating myself like I am right now and have been for years, I'll be rich and influential enough to fully control my own image. I think I've been sent to save cinema. People laugh at me, but they don't understand my mission. They say I'm deluded, but I think I'm perfectly looted.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, that's nice. I like that one. That's nice. Yeah.
Yeah, that's alright.
No, I'm not done yet. Hold on, go.
Hello. Why is there so much apple juice?
I fucking love apple juice. I fucking love apple juice. When it comes to my apple juice, nothing's off the table. That is, including my alcohol. Vodka, whiskey, rum, fucking Baileys and Kahlua. I even mix it with apple cider to get the extra apple twang. Patent pending.
In the past 2 weeks, which is how long it took me to get all the logistics and that down for the story, I haven't really done many of the things that a regular human being does to function. I haven't really eaten much, gone to the toilet that much, bathed, washed, whatever you want to call it. I've just been doing this. It's just the kind of sacrifices I have to make for art. I mean, I've had a lot of energy drinks, as you can tell by that wall. But you know, it's like what Jay-Z said, difficult takes a day, impossible takes a week. And this took me two.
So did you adopt the idea?
I don't want to go to the gym.
What are you doing?
I'm thinking. Because I've already got the idea for my film. But then there's like 10 other things I need to check off. I need an actor, cameraman, VFX, editing. Actually, no, that's me. Boom operator. No, that comes with the cameraman. No, okay, maybe just three things then. Or was it two? I don't know. It doesn't matter. My mate James will be up for it though. He's always down for anything. I mean, this is a good fucking film, you know? Yeah, I'll give him a ring, hold on.
Yes, James, what's up? Okay, I was only asking. Look, come over to mine, I got something to show you. Well, as soon as possible. Leave college. I don't give a fuck that you're at college, okay? Come over to mine. No. Okay, just as quick as possible then. Come on. Chop, chop. Secure the bag.
Oh, that's it. Hey, James. Hello.
You alright?
Come in.
Who's this?
Oh, he's with me. He's making the documentary about me.
What, you mean the film documentary?
No, the one about me, anyway. Don't worry. Go upstairs.
Huh?
Okay, come in.
Jesus, mate, you live like this.
Look, what do you mean? It's normally like this. Shut up. Anyway, take a seat. Hold on.
What the fuck?
Where? My PowerPoint is not here.
What are you talking about?
My presentation, it's gone.
What presentation?
My pitch, I need to show you my pitch.
Pitch?
Pitches are bad. It's a sign that the next few weeks are going to be absolutely miserable. And a sign that misery's already begun. One time it called me 47 times because I was late to a shoot. Except I wasn't late. He told me 12, but expected me to be at 11 to prove that I'm enthusiastic enough. I mean, I love Finley, he's one of my best friends, but his film cycles are the worst. The worst.
Are you in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, we're here on set for my new Western short film. It's called A Barrel Full of Fury, like a barrel on a revolver with six bullets, never mind. Don't have a cameraman yet, but it's all right. My mate Kamara Man has agreed to be the cameraman. His legal name is Kamara Man, like
Kamara, surname Man with two N's. I don't know if he was born here. You know, his name sounds a bit exotic. But, yeah, he's an alcoholic due to years of bullying due to his shit name. And also, he's a cameraman because it's like destiny. He also only talks in grunts. Like, he just goes, So, he's a bit of an acquired taste, but I think we'll get to like him. Kamara? Hello?
Hey. You alright?
I told you he was a fucking alcoholic. Look at all that shit.
At least he's got good taste and he's been drinking the Red Stripes and all that.
Do you want to be the cameraman?
Hmm?
Cameraman?
Hmm?
For my film?
Hmm.
Oh. That's good. He just said yes. What's that? Oh, shit! Okay. That's a prop gun. We need some of them. Do you have any more?
Hmm?
Where are they?
Hmm.
Home?
Hmm.
Can you go get them?
Hmm.
Okay. Go. Go. Go and get them, Kamara. You're a champion. I think he's really drunk. I'm not a mute. Finley's just a cunt. We've been waiting here for like an hour for Kamara to fucking hurry his sorry little ass up. But he's not here. I think he got lost or something.
Oh shit.
He's back. He
did it. Did you get the guns?
Where's that? This. Okay, well this isn't cowboy accurate. This is fucking 500 years old. What the fuck is this? It's a fucking assault rifle. Fuck. Don't worry, it's just a prop gun.
What's this then?
It's my cowboy costume. Look, it's got cowboy in the back.
That's just your regular clothes.
No, it's not. I mean, I see myself as a cowboy anyway. We're going to do a couple scenes today. You know, we've got me as the cowboy protagonist and James, reveal yourself.
Hell yeah.
Cowboy antagonist and, oh, I don't know who that is. Who are you?
Come.
What?
You told me to come.
Okay, all right, let's just get this shit done. I don't know why a woman's here.
No, get out the fuck. Okay, look, you stand there, yeah? Stay out of the way. Make sure you get both of us in it, okay? You need to actually act, right?
Fuck you!
No,
prick.
You're just standing there. You have to actually be menacing.
You're not. You're a fucking cunt.
You're a prick.
You're a fucking prick. You're a prick.
You suck, man. You're fuck shit. You. Oh, Jay, you hit me in the teeth. Oh.
Fuck you.
It's too far.
No, James, okay, you've got to actually act mad at me. You're like, you're not doing a good job.
Are you fucking serious? You know what, yeah, I'm done with this shit. No, you can't just walk away because you're a bad actor.
Who wants to fucking talk, yeah? You're the worst fucking filmmaker I've ever seen. Like Jared Leto if he was a director instead of a fucking actor.
No, okay, well, you're just a bad friend. There's nothing...
What the fuck? No, don't go. Think about what you're giving up.
I hate you when he leaves, but I love seeing him walk away.
Fuck, man, it's fuck. It's all fucking ruined. I've lost my lead actor.
He threw a fucking carton of apple juice at me. A fucking carton of apple juice.
It's still good though. I don't know what I'm gonna do now. My lead actor's gone. Oh, bollocks. I'm gonna have to use the girl, aren't I? This movie's fucked.
No. Use the flower one, because you're a girl. Yeah, perfect.
And like that, it's done. I finally finished editing together my magnum opus. I'm gonna have a premiere tonight in my lounge. I'm gonna get all the people involved in the film down and also a couple of my mates if they make the cut, because I want them to see it too. This piece of modern mastery.
Just a hand.
3, 4, 5.
Is that right? Is that right?
got to make a couple calls first, you know, see who's actually available to come down. Hopefully they'll put everything on hold, you know, because this is just more important than whatever they're doing tonight.
No, all right, mate. Okay, cool. No worries. Don't worry. What do you mean you have work? No, look, but is this important? Fuck. Fuck.
I made a few phone calls, had a few, artistic disagreements. It's fine. They'll bring the party down anyways. I'm just going to make an Instagram story for people who I actually like, and then they'll come down instead. No biggie.
Alright, we'll get some, like, cowboy stickers in it or something. Oh, look, it's Jack Black. Doing, like, the nay-nay. Perfect. Look at that.
That's willing to attract some customers.
Send that to my story. Hopefully, some people show up this time.
Today is the big day. Today is the premiere of my new film. I sent the Instagram invites out a couple days ago. I have a few confirmed attendees. Pretty sure James is going to come, which would be good. You know, we're going to re-patch together our friendship. And I imagine, like, some people I'm not really mates with on Instagram will turn up too. I hope. They probably will though. I'm gonna go wait and greet them at the door when they show up. No one showed up. Nobody showed up. Which is fine. That would have ruined it. I'm just gonna go upstairs and upload the film myself without them. And none of them can have any of the prize money, which I was gonna give to them if they had showed up.
We have to email it to the showrunners, whatever they're called. So there it is, magnoopus.mp4, cheeky little name. Done. That's good. Hold on.
What the fuck? What's going on with my screen?
What's wrong? What the fuck? Oh shit. Goodbye, Finley. What the fuck?
I forget.
What the fuck?
What the fuck? What the fuck?